I have one small comment and just two questions about Article number 50. First of all, of course, like I think 2009, nobody didn't really expect that the Article 50 should be like really activated. But on the same time, we have to always understand that if you're putting something to the law or to the treaties, then it should be also possible to really use them if the time comes. Do we like it or not? That's another question. But just if you're putting like to the treaties, to the law, it's understandable that it has to be prepared to be ready for using. The second question is about the main values and democracy. If the member states wants to join with the EU, then how democratic it should be like if there is no legal possibility from the treaties also to leave the EU? Because in most of the countries, the process to join with the EU has been through the local constitution, through the local law, and through the referendum, normally. So, and if the people will say, yes, we want to join with the EU, we'll give the mandate, the political mandate to the government to have negotiations with the EU, then it should be very undemocratic if there is no possibility also to leave the EU. So that's the main, like the basic question. And I really don't have no idea that how it was working before 2009 to join with the EU without any possibility to leave the EU. The first speaker mentioned about the citizens who has to be involved in the process when they are leaving the EU, and also the last speaker mentioned that many times the citizens doesn't really know what it comes after leaving the EU, what it really means, that what are the consequences. But then I have also a question that, do they really know very well what it means to join with the EU? That has to be fair from both sides. You have to know exactly what comes when you're joining, what are the responsibilities, consequences, and also what comes if you're leaving. It has to be very clear before you're deciding what to do, in which way you will go. But those two questions, in Article 50, there is nothing mentioned about the monetary union and the leaving the monetary union. So if those previous professors could just comment very shortly, do they see a need to also mention in the treaties the possible access of a member state who's also part of the monetary union, and if they want to leave, how it should be like legally. And the second question is that couldn't it be possible, or there is need to put it to a treaties, if the member state who's also part of the monetary union wants to only leave the monetary union, but still wants to remain part of the European Union? Because those questions are not mentioned in the treaties today. Thank you very much.